6 a.m. Wait, is it 6? Oh, it's 6:11 a.m.
Oh shit, we gotta go.
Llama music, guys.
It's so early. Llama, 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 llama.
This is the Wes Anderson Stacy Zoo soundtrack. This cloud is like tripping me out. Spaceship cloud.
Gotcha.
Wow!
Majestic.
Good to meet you. So cute.
Shelf over there if you want to put stuff down, and the benches. So a little bit about them. We adopted them from a horse rescue. This is Ema, and Ema's the mama to Ishel. They're all like, where have you been?
We're here with llamas. Hi, how's it going? I like being surrounded by llamas. It feels good.
Hey.
You're so vain. They're into it, I think.
Well, the ears up. Ears up means happy.
So if their chin goes up like this.
Surrender, you're surrounded, Puno.
I like you.
I like you.
Llama mama, love me. Some pellets for you.
I have to grab these.
So some pellets for me.
Vogue. Vogue. This one's the most gentle.
He's so nice. Wow. Okay. Okay.
They're into it.
We're almost done here. Ooh! Ooh! I'm not a tree. It's pretty loose, actually. Ooh. Wow!
Woo!
Just ran into the bush.
He's showing off.
U-turn.
I think I'm gonna get this cell phone. Hello, Palm Springs. Llama on. Nice. Doing a little pit stop here. Yeah, Joshua Tree. So cute. Whoa.
Okay, cut.
My butt.
Okay, so I haven't been vlogging and there's just no way because I've been trying to get ready for this stand-up showcase. So you know I've been taking my stand-up class for like 10 weeks. Well, today is the showcase. It's been tough. We're rewriting jokes in the last minute and then I have to memorize them. This morning I talked to my teacher, Jerry, and like we cut half of my jokes. Here I go. Got my set list. This is the hardest thing I have done in a while, I have to say. That's what this is a learning experience. Okay, I'm gonna go in now. This is it, the haha club. Ha 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 ha. So, no one's here yet, just Jacob. Let's see.
Yeah, there's other weird fetishes you develop growing up in the South. Pickup trucks are another one I didn't quite realize until I moved out to California. You know, growing up in North Carolina, it was like, there was Evan from youth group at church, and he drove a giant black Ford F-150.
Frosting. People assume I speak Korean. I don't speak Korean. Mostly because my parents did not teach me Korean.
Miley Castillo! James Denise! Woo! Puno!
Woo!
Margaret Hyde!
Woo!
Thanks
express like how much anxiety I had. You know, we had been doing this class for 10 weeks. Really wasn't until the last 2 or 3 days that I was like, okay, I think I got my set. And then like every day I had my set, I would call Jerry and then it would just completely change for the better, but still it was like so frustrating. We did the rehearsal and you know, it's just me up there with my classmates. Every line, I just forgot it. I went completely blank and I was like, shoot. There's a point where we were like, okay, let's all go and like say hi to, you know, people who came. I didn't do it because I was like, I'll take the next 15 minutes and just sit here and like memorize, go through the lines again. I got up and I saw some of my friends. I was like immediately at ease. Immediately. It was incredible. Like, and I was so surprised by it because the level of anxiety that I had was just so overwhelming. And then right when I like saw some of my friends and they were just like, you know, the happy-go-lucky self, I was like, so happy that I invited people. I didn't want to invite a lot of people just because I didn't want to make a big deal out of it, you know? There's like baggage about that, right? Like, I don't want people to think that I'm trying to be a stand-up comedian. This is for me. This is not to prove to anyone else. Like, I just want to prove it to myself. I started telling people, like, can you just please come because I'm like super duper nervous and it would just be really awesome if I could have somebody there to like laugh at every line just in case it doesn't work. People were like, yeah, of course. Of course I'll be there. So, oh, I'm just so glad. I'm like already reliving that part again. I was like, I saw Hannah and I was like, oh, I started crying because I was just like so happy that I wasn't feeling anxious anymore. It was like this crazy, like, oh my God, I'm gonna be fine. I go up, I'm on stage, but I like literally jumped and skipped on there. The first line I said, like, I think one of my friends, I think G like yelled and it just was like so funny and out of nowhere. So I think it made everybody laugh. While I was up there, holy crap, like I'm remembering it all. I'm not blanking. And it was so nice that people would laugh because I'm just kind of like kind of listening so that I can know how long I need for the next one. And then I just be like, what's the next freaking thing I gotta say? Jeez, right? It's like, it sounds like the most horrible thing ever. This was my biggest fear. I faced it. And it was the hardest thing I've ever done. And people were like, oh, are you gonna do this again? And I was just thinking, I don't even know, man. Like, I need a moment. I just need a second to like process all of this and allow myself to like celebrate the moment just a little bit because I haven't. It was just like, ha ha! I woke up relieved that it was over. But man, so glad that I did it though.